Oh, namaste, myself M.S. Basargon, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to solve Legendre's linear differential equation. Now, first we'll see what is Legendre linear equation. An equation of the form ax plus b raised to n into d raised to n y by dx raised to n plus k1 into ax plus b raised to n minus 1 into d raised to n minus 1 y by dx raised to n minus 1 and so on plus k suffix n minus 1 into bracket ax plus b dy by dx plus kn y equal to x, where k1, k2 and so on kn are constants and x is function of x. Now, such equations can be reduced to linear equation with constant coefficients by the standard substitution ax plus b equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log of ax plus b. Then dy by dx will become dy by dz into dz by dx. As you know, dz by dx is 1 by ax plus b into a, that is equal to dy by dz into a upon ax plus b, that is we can write ax plus b into dy by dx equal to a into d of y. Here d stands for d by dz. Similarly, ax plus b whole square d square y by dx square equal to we get a square into d minus 1 of y. And ax plus b raised to 3 into d cube y by dx cube is equal to a cube into d minus 1 into d minus 2 of y and so on. After making this substitution in equation number 1, we get a linear differential equation with constant coefficients. Now, question is, reduce the following differential equation into linear differential equation with constant coefficients. Pause the video for a while and reduce this given equation to linear differential equation with constant coefficients. I hope you have completed. Now here given equation is 5x plus 2 whole square into d square y by dx square plus into bracket 5x plus 2 dy by dx plus 10y equal to 6x. This is a Legendre linear differential equation. Comparing with Legendre's equation, here a is 5 and b equal to 2. Put 5x plus 2 equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log of 5x plus 2, so that 5x plus 2 dy by dx equal to 5 into d of y and 5x plus 2 whole square d square y by dx square equal to a square means 25 d into d minus 1 of y. Then the given equation becomes 25d into d minus 1 plus 5d plus 10 of y equal to 6 into substituting the value of x, that is e raised to z minus 2 by 5, that is 25 d square minus 20 d plus 10 of y equal to 6 into e raised to z minus 2 whole divided by 5. Now we will solve the complete example. Solve 2x plus 3 whole square into d square over dx square plus 2x plus 3 into dy by dx minus 2y equal to 24x square. This is a clearly Legendre's equation. Comparing with Legendre's equation, here a is 2 and b is equal to 3. Put 2x plus 3 equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log of 2x plus 3. So that 2x plus 3 into dy by dx is equal to 2 into d of y. And 2x plus 3 whole square d square y by dx square equal to 4 into d minus 1 of y. Substituting these values, then the given equation becomes 4 into d minus 1 plus 2d minus 2 of y is equal to 24. Substituting the value of x, that is e raised to z minus 3 by 2 whole square. That is, simplifying this, we get 4d square minus 4d plus 2d minus 2 of y is equal to 24 by 2 square, means that is 4 into e raised to z minus 3 whole square. That is 4d square minus 4d plus 2d, that is minus 2d minus 2 of y is equal to 6 into, taking the square of this, we get e raised to 2z minus 6 e raised to z plus 9. Now dividing throughout by 2, we get 2d square minus d minus 1 of y is equal to 3 into bracket e raised to 2z minus 6 e raised to z plus 9. Now this is a linear differential equation with constant coefficient, and its auxiliary equation is 2d square minus d minus 1 equal to 0, and its roots are d equal to 1 plus or minus square root of 1 plus 8 by 4, that is 1 plus or minus 3 by 4, that is 4 by 4, and minus 2 by 4, that is d equal to 1 and d equal to minus half. Therefore, the complementary function is given by Cf is equal to c1 e raised to z plus c2 e raised to minus 1 by 2 z. Now, we will calculate the particular integral. Particular integral is what? 1 by f of d. Here, f of d is 2d square minus d minus 1 of 3 into e raised to 2z minus 6 e raised to z plus 9, which is equal to 3 into, we can separate into 3 parts, 1 by 2d square minus d minus 1 of e raised to 2z minus 6 into 1 by 2d square minus d minus 1 of e raised to z plus 9 into 1 by 2d square minus d minus 1 of e raised to 0z. Now here, by using the formula of 1 by f of d of e raised to ax, and if you put the value of d as a 2, we get 1 by 2 into 4 minus 2 minus 1 of e raised to 2z minus 6z into 1 by 4d minus 1 of e raised to z plus 9 into 1 by 0 minus 0 minus 1 of e raised to z, which is equal to 3 into bracket, that is 8 minus 3, 1 by 5 e raised to 2z minus 6z into e raised to z by 3, and by simplifying this we get minus 9. Therefore, particular integral is equal to 3 by 5 into e raised to 2z minus 6z into e raised to z minus 27. Then the general solution is given by y equal to cf plus pi. Here cf is c1 e raised to z plus c2 e raised to minus z by 2 plus 3 by 5 into e raised to 2z minus 6z into e raised to z minus 27. Now replacing z by log of 2x plus 3, we get y equal to c1 e raised to log of 2x plus 3 plus c2 into e raised to minus log of 2x plus 3 divided by 2 plus 3 by 5 e raised to twice log of 2x plus 3 minus 6 into log of 2x plus 3 into e raised to log of 2x plus 3 minus 27. By simplifying this, we get y equal to c1 into 2x plus 3 plus c2 into 2x plus 3 raised to minus 1 by 2 plus 3 by 5 into 2x plus 3 whole square minus 6 into 2x plus 3 into log of 2x plus 3 minus 27. Now we'll see one more example. Solve x plus 1 whole square d square y bar dx square plus x plus 1 dy bar dx plus y is equal to log of x plus 1 raised to the power 4 plus cos of log of 1 plus x. Here comparing, we get a equal to 1 and b equal to 1. Now we have to put x plus 1 equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log of x plus 1, so that x plus 1 dy by dx equal to d of y, and x plus 1 whole square d square y by dx square equal to d into d minus 1 of y. Substituting these values in the given equation, we get d into d minus 1 plus d plus 1 of y is equal to z raised to 4 plus cos z. That is, by simplifying this, we get, that is, d square minus d plus 1 of y equal to z raised to 4 plus cos z. That is, d square plus 1 of y equal to z raised to 4 plus cos z. Now, its auxiliary equation is given by d square plus 1 equal to 0, that is d equal to plus or minus I. Here both roots are imaginary, therefore you get Cf is equal to c1 cos z plus c2 sin z. Now Pi is equal to 1 by d square plus 1 of z raised to 4 plus cos z. Now here we have to separate into two parts, that is 1 by d square plus 1 of z raised to 4 plus 1 by d square plus 1 of cos z. We denote first one as a Pi1, second one as a Pi2. Now first we calculate Pi1, that is equal to 1 by d square plus 1 of z raised to 4, because it is a polynomial, therefore we can shift d square plus 1 to the numerator, that is d square plus 1 raised to minus 1 of z raised to 4, which is equal to, expounding this by using binomial expansion, 1 minus d square plus d raised to 4 minus d raised to 6 and so on of z is to 4, which is equal to 1 minus d square plus d raised to 4 of z raised to 4. Because of z raised to 4, here we have considered up to d raised to 4, which is equal to, now operating this bracket on z raised to 4, 1 into z raised to 4 is z raised to 4 minus d square of z raised to 4 plus d raised to 4 of z raised to 4. Now that is equal to z raised to 4, d square of z raised to 4 is minus 12 z square, and d raised to 4 of z raised to 4 means derivative of 4 derivative of z raised to 4 is 24. Now we will calculate pi 2, which is equal to 1 by d square plus 1 of cos z, which is equal to z into 1 by 2d of cos z, because here if you replace d square by minus 1, it is a case of failure. Therefore, we can multiply by z and we can differentiate d square plus 1 with respect to d, that is 1 by 2d of cos z, which is equal to z by 2, 1 by d of cos z means integration of cos z dz, which is equal to z by 2 into integration of cos z is sin z. Therefore, the complete solution is given by y equal to cf plus pi, that is c1 cos z plus c2 sin z plus pi, that is z raised to 4 minus 12 z square plus 24 and plus z by 2 sin z. Now replacing z by log of x plus 1, we get y equal to c1 cos of log of x plus 1 plus c2 sin of log of x plus 1 plus log of x plus 1 raised to 4 minus 12 log of x plus 1 whole square plus 24 plus log of x plus 1 by 2 into sine of log of x plus 1.